Everyone, today we are going to learn the topic type conversion. What is type conversion? So what is type conversion? Converting of a data type or a variable from one type into another is known as type conversion. The process of converting one predefined type into another is called type conversion. So one data type into another data type is known as type conversion. The process of converting from one data type into another data type is known as type conversion. It is divided into two, implicit and explicit. Implicit means automatically done by the compiler. Explicit means user has to do the conversion. Differences between implicit conversion and explicit conversion will surely ask. Even you have reached for 10th standard also, this question is very important. The implicit and explicit conversion. Implicit means it is automatically done by the compiler. Explicitly means user has to do explicitly. The user has to do explicitly. That is, user has to convert explicitly. User has to perform conversion. And another point is, in implicit conversion, conversion from smaller data type to larger. Conversion from smaller data type to larger data type is implicit. It is automatically done by the compiler. Larger data type to smaller data type. Larger data type to smaller data type. Okay? So what is implicit conversion? Conversion of smaller data type into larger data type, and it is automatically done by the compiler. You have to not do anything, and it is also known as coercion. Coercion. It is also known as coercion or type promotion. It is also known as coercion. It is also known as coercion or type promotion. The conversion of smaller data type into larger data type, and it is automatically done by the compiler itself. Explicit conversion means conversion of larger data type into smaller data type, and the user has to do explicitly, and the operator used for performing explicit conversion is typecast operator. Parenthesis. This is known as typecast operator, which is used to convert a larger data type into smaller data type. It is automatically done by the user has to do explicitly. So type conversion means conversion of one data type into another data type. The process of converting one data type into another data type is known as type conversion. It is of two type, implicit conversion and explicit conversion. Implicit conversion is also known as coercion or type promotion. Explicit conversion is also known as typecasting. It's also known as typecasting. So implicit conversion is conversion of smaller data type into larger data type. It is automatically done by the compiler. Whereas explicit is my larger data type into smaller data type. The user has to do explicitly the conversion. The user has to do explicitly the conversion. And using parenthesis, that is typecast operator, we perform explicit conversion. Using typecast operator, we will perform explicit conversion. Short is of how many bytes? 2 bytes. Okay, short is of 2 bytes. And index of 4 bytes. So suppose if you perform short, this is small letter, okay, small, short a is equal to 5 comma b is equal to 2 int a int d is equal to a plus b. See, these both are short. These both are short. That, but we are going to trying to save a short variable into int. These both are short, and we are trying to save this in int. So smaller to larger, this we are not doing anything. Simply we are adding short and we are storing it in int. So the conversion will, this will be converted. Your value 7 will be converted automatically into integer by the compiler itself. You don't need to do anything. That is smaller to larger. It is known as implicit conversion, and it is done by the compiler itself. Now moving to explicit. Int a is equal to 5. Okay. D is equal to 5. Long b is equal to 2. We'll write long b is equal to 2. Long a is equal to 5. Okay, long a is equal to b. And I'm trying to store this int c is equal to a plus b. This will show error. Why? Why? Because these are of type long and this is int. Yes, long is larger and this is smaller. You are trying to copy the larger value into smaller, so it will show error. For that, what you have to do is you have to use a typecast operator. So you have to use a typecast operator. I will show you the conversion. So you have to write int c is equal to which variable you have to convert? You have to convert a plus b. So you have to write, put a bracket, you have to put a bracket, and you have to write, sorry, int bracket close and a plus b. So what it will do means it will perform a plus b and it will be converted into integer, and then it will store in the integer. I will write very neatly so that it will be easy. Int c is equal to in bracket the data type to which you have to convert. You have to convert the long into int. This is long, so you have to convert the long into smaller data type, larger into smaller, that is long into int. So int you will write in bracket and then you will write the expression. Now it will perform addition. Very clear. Many makes mistake by writing int c is equal to int a plus b. This is wrong. The bracket should be come here in the int. So you have to write this way. Okay. Now again, we'll show you an example. Double d is equal to 2.0. F is equal to 6.2. Float e is equal to, how will you do this? Double is larger than float. Larger into smaller means you have to do explicit conversion. Implicit will not work because double is large and you are trying to convert larger value into smaller one. So you have to do it in explicitly. So what you have to do is in bracket you have to convert double into float. So float, you have to convert double into float d plus f. So this double value will be added and it is converted into float, and then it will be stored in e. Now this will be correct. Okay, so what to which data type you have to convert, you have to mention in that bracket. The syntax is shown here. So the type is to which data type the expression has to be converted. Here x plus y by 2 has to be converted into float. That is why they have written float. So the operator which is used for performing explicit type conversion is typecasting. They have shown one more thing. If in an expression it contains a here int d is equal to Here in an expression, if it contains a character and an integer, it will be converted into higher value. Automatically it performs a conversion and it will be converted into higher value. Okay, that is type promotion. Here character is of 2 bytes, integer is of how many bytes? 4 bytes. So larger is 4. So if you have character and integer, it will be converted into integer. It will be converted into integer. Plus you have a float and a double. Which one is larger? Double. So it will be promoted into double. Implicit conversion. And here you have float and int. Float is big or int is big? Float is big. It has higher precision. So float. Again this expression has, this is one expression. So it will take each expression and then convert. Then FD by FI, that is FD by FI means FI is float and FD, it is not FD, it is LD. DB it is. That's wrong, they have given FD, this is DB. DB and float. No, they have already, LD and float. Long double is LD. Long double it is LD. Okay, it's LD and it is they have given float. Long double and double. Leave this portion. It is wrong. Okay. So again this plus this. So its data type is int. Its data type is double. So int plus double. Int is smaller. Double is larger. So again it is converted into double. Type promotion. So if in an expression there are many data types, mixed expression means what? It contains many data types. So at the end the result will be of bigger data type. At the end the result will be of bigger data type. Here int double, so double. Next double and float. It will take after converting these two, it will come to this. Double and float. Float is smaller, double is larger, so double. Again this. This is double, you have got output, double plus double, automatically double. So how will you find the result expressions data type means? First you take each expression and you will compare character and int, which one is smaller and which one is larger. So larger will be the result, int is larger, so your result data type is int. So this way you will solve the expression. It is type promotion. Smaller into larger. Promotion means what? It's from small designation to higher designation. Same way, from smaller data type to larger data type means type promotion, that is implicit conversion. From larger to smaller is explicit conversion. Explicit conversion, they have given a table. Int to int, no need of the conversion. Int to long, int is smaller, long is larger. So smaller to larger, it will perform implicit conversion. A indicates the precision is increasing, so automatic cast, that means implicit. And N means conversion is not allowed, C means explicit. Okay, C explicit, A implicit, N conversion is not allowed. Int to long, smaller. Smaller to larger, implicit conversion. Long to int, larger to smaller, explicit. That is why C. Float to int, float is larger, int is smaller, so again explicit conversion. See, one more thing here, int to boolean, it cannot be converted. How will you convert 2 into true or false? We cannot convert, so not applicable. We cannot convert any data type into boolean. We cannot convert any data type into boolean. Here also we cannot convert any data type into boolean. We cannot convert any data type into boolean and we cannot convert boolean into any data type. Okay, no conversion is possible between this. Short to int, short is smaller, int is larger, so implicit. Short to float, again this is all implicit conversion. Double to int, double is bigger, int is smaller, so larger to smaller, explicit conversion. C using typecast operator. So if you want to convert a, you write double D is equal to 2. Is there any wrong in this question? 2 is an integer number. I am trying to save it in D. It will show error. No, this is correct. Why it is correct? This is int, it is smaller. So the compiler will automatically convert the int into double and your output will be 2.0. Okay, implicit, it is not wrong, it perform implicit conversion because int is smaller and it will be automatically converted into larger and you will get the output 2.0. What about int c is equal to 2.0? Int c is equal to 2.0. This is double and this is int. Double is larger. When you try to save larger into smaller, then it will show error. So for this, what you have to do? You have to write int c is equal to, you have to convert this double into integer. So you have to convert the double into integer. So int, your value 2.0. So automatically 2.0 will be converted into integer and your output will be 2. Clear? This is explicit conversion. Okay? Tell us very clearly, larger data type to smaller data type is explicit conversion. User have to do the conversion explicitly using a typecast operator bracket. Whereas implicit conversion means conversion of a smaller data type into larger data type. It is done automatically by the compiler. It is done automatically by the compiler. You can give example. That's the third point. First point is the conversion of smaller into larger data type. Smaller data type into larger data type. And it is automatically done by the compiler for implicit conversion. Double D is equal to 2 is an example for conversion. Your output will be 2.0. 2 is integer, which is smaller. Double is larger. So smaller to larger, the compiler will automatically do. Whereas here, this will show error because 2.0 is double. And see, int is smaller. Double is larger and int is smaller. So larger to smaller, a conversion is not possible. It will show error. So you have to use explicit conversion. For that, you use typecast operator. And this double is first converted into integer. And then you will get the output 2. Okay. Now we will move to the solution for some expression. How to solve an expression? I will show you expressions. Here they have shown an expression. Int a comma mb is equal to 2, k is equal to 4. How will you, and your expression is mb into 3 by 4 plus k by 4 plus 8 minus mb in plus 5 by 8. So how will you solve? You have to solve the division first because it has higher priority. Okay, so 5 by 8, both are integer numbers. So it evaluates to 0.625. Your result is 5.8's result is 0.625, but both are integer. I've already discussed when you perform integer division, you will only get integer value. When you perform integer division, even if it has a decimal value, your result will be integer only, that is 0. 5 by 8, when you divide, it will give 0.625, but both are integer, so it will give only integer result, so 0. And minus mb is 2 plus 8, k by 4, k is 4, so 4 by 4 is 1, 4 by 4 is 1, plus 3 by 4 that we will do later, mb is 2 star, okay. Now 3 by 4, again it's an integer, so you will get 3 by 4, mb into 3 by 4, here instead of 3 performing 3 by 4, it will perform 2 into 3. It will perform 2 into 3. You know why? Because into has higher priority. Into has higher priority than division. Into has higher priority than division. So it will perform 6 by 4 plus 1 plus 8 minus 2 plus 0. So 6 by 4 is, you will get the 6 by 3, evaluate to 1.5. 6 by 4 is, result is 1.5. Again, both are integer division. So it will take the result 1. So it is equal to 1 plus 8 minus 2 plus 0. 1 plus 1, 2 plus 8 minus 2 plus 0. 10 minus 2, 8. Your result will be 8. Listen, you have operator precedence. Operator precedence means as your bedmast rule, Indu has higher priority, bracket has higher priority than Indu, then division, then modulus, then plus and then minus. Okay? So, here in this expression, they have given MB star 3 by 4 plus K by 4 plus 8 minus MB plus 5 by 8 means MB star 3 will be performed, that is 2 into 3 divided by 4 plus K by 4 is 4 by 4 plus 8 minus 2 plus 5 by 8. Okay, so 2 into 3 is 6 by 4 plus 1 plus 8 minus 2 plus 5 by 8's result is 0.625. Integer division 0 and 6 by 4 its value is 1.5. So integer division again 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 8 minus 2, that is 10 minus 2, which is equal to 8. This way you have to solve everything. Clear about this? Now I want to again remind you one thing. Here suppose this is a statement, system.order.println my ages. Whatever come inside double quotes, it will be printed as it is. So in your output it will be my age is equal to, and there is a plus, so it will perform concatenation with this. So age, there is no double quotes, it means that it is a variable. So if you want to print the value of a variable, you have to put it is outside the double quotes. You have to put it outside the double quotes. Suppose if age is 13, suppose age is equal to 13, here it will be printed the age, my age is 13. See, they have shown you system.order.println my ages. Message in quotes, variable without quotes. Always remember this. Whatever you have to print as it is, you should put it in the double quotes. And whatever you have to print the value, a value of a variable, you have to put outside the double quotes. If you want to print the message, you have to put inside the double quotes. If you have to print the value of a variable, you have to put outside the double quotes. Okay, so suppose if your age is 13, it will print my age is 13 instead of age. Clear? Always remember this. Thank you.